A very good morning, dear children. Welcome back to the class. Hope you all are doing good, children. So, as we have started with our new lesson, that is measurement, right? So, we'll continue with it today. So, let's start the class. So, children, let's start the class. So, let's do the warm-up activity first. Identify which one is fat. So, you can see here two cats are here. So, out of these two cats, children, which one is the fatter one? Which one is a fat one? Top one or the bottom one? Whichever is, just write down the answer in your copy. Okay? So, let's start with our today's topic. Learning outcomes. Students will be able to measure short hands using hand span, cubit, foot and pace. So, children, today you will understand about this non-standard units of measurement. These are called non-standard units of measurement. Why are these called non-standard unit of measurement, children? Today we will understand. Okay, in today's class we will understand. So before starting with our exercise, children, I would like to show you one small video. Try to understand that.
Non-standard units. In this module, you will learn how to measure an object or place using non-standard units of length.
Measurement of lengths using non-standard units. We can measure a length with the help of body parts. They are called non-standard units. These non-standard units give a rough estimate of length as they differ from person to person. Some of them are hand span.
Now, children, have you understood why it is called non-standard unit of measurement? Because the size of the body differs from person to person, right? The hand span, the size of the hand span of my hand, children, is it will be big from your hand, right? So it differs from person to person. This is why this is called non-standard unit of measurement. The first non-standard unit of measurement is hand span. Hand span, you can see, starts from the tip of the thumb to the till the small finger. Okay, tip of the small finger. This is your hand span.
Cubit.
This is cubit, children, the measurement which we take from the elbow to the tip of the finger.
Fingers. Palm. Foot span. Pace. Hand span. It is the distance from the tip of the thumb to the tip of the little finger in a stretched hand.
Understood? We measure from tip of the thumb till the tip of the little finger.
For example, the length.
And just see how to measure with hand span.
Of this table is about 5 hand span.
So when it was measured using the hand span, children, how many hand span came? 5. So what we will say, the length of the table is 5 hand span. Okay. How long it is? It is 5 hand span long.
Cubit. It is the distance between the tip of the finger to the elbow.
It is a distance between the tip of the finger till elbow, and it is called what? Cubit. C-U-B-I-T. Cubit. Now just see, children, after this how he will keep the another cubit.
The length of this bamboo stick is about 3 cubits.
So, how many cubits he got? How long is this bamboo? 3 cubits. Understood? This is how we measure using the parts of the body.
Fingers. It is the unit of distance equal to the width of 4 fingers closely pressed together. For example, the length of this book is about 4 fingers. Palm. It is the unit of distance equal to the length of the hand from the wrist to the end of the middle finger. For example, The length of this scale is about 3 palm. Foot span. It is the unit of distance based on the length of actual feet. For example, the length of this room is about 20 foot spans.
So how many foot span is this? 20 foot span. How many feet he is taking, that all the feet is counted as, this is called foot span. Okay, this is also one of the way of measuring length of the room. So he measured how many foot span he, how many foot he took, steps he took, 20. So it is called, how what will be the length? You will say it is 20 foot span long, okay?
Pace. It is the distance between two successive falls of the same foot. Thus,
see, it is a distance between two successive foot. So you can see what, how the, what is the gap? This is called pace, okay?
One pace is equal to two steps. For example, the length of this cricket pitch is about 22 paces.
Let's recap. We have learned that the non...
So children, have you got some idea about the non-standard units of measurement? Okay, now let's come back to our chapter. So today we are going to do non-standard unit of measurement. That is hand span, foot span, cubit and pace. Clear? So everyone take out your maths book. Page number. So you can see here page number 41. Write down here today's date. Today's date is 6/1/21. In olden days, people measured lengths and distance using handspan, cubit, foot, pace. Earlier children, in olden days, people used body parts to measure the lengths and the distance. Okay? To measure length, we use one of these methods. We read, like handspan, cubit, foot and pace are called non-standard units of measurement. So if it is asked, what is non-standard units of measurement? Handspan, cubit, foot and pace are called non-standard units of measurement. Okay, why it is called non-standard units of measurement? Because the size of the body is different, isn't it? Everyone has different size of body. Now let's do example 1. Read a few examples of measurement of length. Example 1. Measure the following objects with the given handspan. Note down your answer. One is done for you. So let's do, take out page number 42. So this is what? So you can see what is the length of this object. This is one of the object, children. So what is the length? It is measured with the handspan, right? So how many handspans are there? 3. 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 3. What is the length? 3 handspans. Okay? Now, you can see the table. So what is the length of this table? You can measure with the handspan. How many handspans you can see here? 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many handspans are here? 6. So the answer is 6. Clear? Next, this is a laptop. What is the length? How many handspans you can see here? 3, right? So what is the length? 3 handspans. Now let's measure the length of the window. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what will come here? 5. Done? Okay, then let's do example 2. Measure these objects with the given cubits. Write down your answer. One is done for you. So this is what? This is the measuring this is measured with cubit, right? So let's see how many cubits you can see here. 3. So what is the length? 3 cubits. Okay. Next, page number 43. This is doormat. So how many cubits you can see? 2. So what will be the answer? Number of cubits are 2. Okay. Then how many cubits you can see here on the table? So what is the length of the table, children? 4 cubits, right? So this is how you can do of blackboard and sofa, okay? So you can write the answer, you can do it yourself. Next, name an object each whose length is equal to your handspan, cubit and foot. Name an object each, okay? Any object like TV or any object like doormat, if you take the measurement with handspan, then also the answer is same, measurement is same. If you measure with cubit, then also the answer is same. And if you measure with foot, even then the answer is length is equal. Okay, think over it, children. Then we'll discuss the answer to this question in our next class. Now next, example 3. Read a few real life examples which involves measuring the length of some objects. So children, this we will do it in our next class. For today, you do it this example 1 and 2 in your book. Okay, hope it is clear to everyone. So what we have studied today, children, about the non-standard your units of measurement, that is handspan, cubit, foot and pace. Okay, so let's do this. New words and match the following. So children, these are the new words which you have learned today. So write down these new words in your copy and see the question in the screen, children, and write the answer in your copy. You have to match handspan. Which one is the handspan, children? A, B, C, D. So whichever the answer is, you have to write 1, B, 1, A, whatever the answer is, you just write down in your copy. Okay, 3, see this match and match with the correct option, correct picture. So can we use cubit to measure bed, children? Think over it. Number 2, measure the TV of your home using handspan. Try, children, and find the length of the TV. Okay, so a length of the screen. So children, you can use the, you can do this at home. Clear? Is it clear about the non-standard units of measurement, children? Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.